Anna Wewe. Viongozi wetu wote wa kanisa, tumesikia sauti zenu mkisema ya kwamba mnataka viongozi sisi wote tukiwa pamoja, roho ya ubinafsi isituingie, tujue ya kwamba yale tunafanya, yale tunapendekeza, yale tunatarajia isiwe ni mambo ya kibinafsi ya viongozi. Tujue Kenya kuna Wakenya milioni 45 na wao wako na haki kama vile viongozi wako na haki, na mambo yao kwa sasa wanajali sana vile watoto wao watasoma, vile biashara zao zitaamka tena, vile nafasi zao za kazi zilizopotea zitapatikana tena, vile tutafufua uchumi, vile tutahakikisha kwamba corona haiwezi kudhuru wananchi wengi. That is the primary concern of every Kenyan in Kenya today. And therefore, as spiritual leaders tell us, we must not invite the spirit of selfishness in whatever we do. We must be minded that 45 million Kenyans have clarity in what is priority to them at the moment. And even as we go into the future, we must carry the whole country as we make the decisions that we are going to make. And I want to agree that we must move together. We must carry all Kenyans together, because that's our primary responsibility as leaders, given by responsibilities given to us both by the Constitution and the people of Kenya, to move the country as one, and that we shall not leave others behind.
Nimeona juzi the suspended CEO of KEMSA in the Senate disclosing those who are giving him instructions to give tenders in a selective manner, exaggerated pricing, and not following the law, our procurement laws, and he named people. Some time back, we were being told that we have a pure motive in fighting corruption. And today we must ask ourselves, did we really as a nation have pure motives? Were we prepared to fight corruption in this country? That today when a CEO is being suspended, and most likely he was being suspended so that he does not say the truth, and I want to encourage that former CEO to continue speaking out and telling us who are these who are instructing him. And since he has told us, people must now take what they told others to do. They must take political responsibility. If you have been mentioned as having given illegal instructions, don't tell us like those who told us before that they would rather die than resign. Please leave public office. Huwezi tumia pandemic kama hii kuiba pesa ya wagonjwa na watu wanakufa. Mchungaji, you are sending the deputy president to the minister, the CS for health and education. Na nimekusikiza, ujue nimekusikiza, nilisikia ukisema sababu mnawatafuta hawachukui simu. Na deputy president ulimpigia, akachukua na akaja kanisani. Lakini waziri mwenye amepewa kazi ya kufanyia wa Kenya na kulinda watoto wetu, hachukui simu ya mchungaji. Lakini usijali, tutawaombea na nitakuuliza uwaombee, wajue kuchukua simu na wajue kuwa na a pure motive. Wasituite fellow Kenyans, let's sanitize, let's wash our hands, let's keep social distance, and you are not sanitizing from corruption money. You are not sanitizing yourself or keeping social distance from public funds. I want to tell the CS Health, the PS Health, and all those others who have been mentioned in this COVID haste, please keep social and physical distance from public funds, and also keep physical distance from public office and quit your jobs. Allow investigations to carry on, to be carried on when you're out of office. Sababu huo ndio mtindo tulionyesho. Wakati wengine walikuwa mentioned, waliambiwa step aside, uchunguzi ifanywe. Kwa nini hii iwe tofauti? Nataka niseme, tuseme bila uoga. When we set aside 30% of public procurement for our youth, women and people living with disabilities, it was for everybody, not some people. Therefore, you cannot selectively select and direct who will be given public procurement without following the law. And therefore, I want to ask, even being in charge, that we take political responsibility even as we seek to protect our nation from this pandemic, but also ask the church to continue speaking out. I am glad I've seen the Catholic bishop speak out. The rest of us in church should speak out.